Thank you. So, ladies and gentlemen, the Elliots of Newton, Elliots of Newbury, Eon for short, primary glider, actually developed from a German design. A huge number of these were built. They were used throughout the United Kingdom by the Air Training Corps and the Combined Cadet Force under the name of the Eon Eaton. It started in 1948. And of course, air cadet units couldn't afford a tug aircraft. So how they got them airborne was fascinating. You get a large bunch of mates, all the cadets, at one end of the airfield. You have this aircraft at the other end of the airfield with the cadets sat in it. And you have a bunch of his friends hanging onto the tailplane. In between them is an enormous bungee cord, basically a giant elastic band. And when you nod your head, all your mates on the tailplane let go, and you literally get catapulted across the field. And that, ladies and gentlemen, was the first time many air cadets had ever actually been flying. Your first flight in this aircraft was also your first solo. Can you imagine health and safety at landing that today? Maximum speed of 73 miles an hour, would you believe? On this particular design, we have the 32A Tiger Moth, one of the most famous training aircraft in the Second World War. Every time I look at Tiger Moths, I keep on finding out something else about them that I didn't know.
Shuttleworth on the 2nd of June, and then hop the ferry down.
found anomaly. Now, this is down as one of our Vietnam aircraft. There's a very good reason for that, because not only did Air America, the sneaky-beaky CIA unit, use the aircraft as a transport, the US Air Force did too. They were transporting goods in and out of jungle strips all over Southeast Asia. But they had another role as well. They put 3 6-barrel miniguns, and their 7.62 Gatling gun, 3 of them down the side of the fuselage, firing sideways. The Spooky, which was its official moniker, and they were the first gunships. This is this aircraft is known as the AC-47 in that role. That gunship role was later taken over by the Fairchild C-119 Packet, which carried more and heavier guns, and of course is still fulfilled today by the Lockheed C-130 Hercules. Special Squadron Spectre is down at Holman Field in the panhandle of Florida. They still carry on that role today, very, very effective aircraft. But you wouldn't have thought, one built, mass production Colossus Gladiator Mark 1, built in 1937, assembled in 1938.
Thank you.
said the last biplane fighter ever to serve in the Royal Air Force. Unusual in having a fully enclosed cockpit. Most aircraft of the day still open cockpits.
I should have been a bit more than a bad door.
do was cut World War One V8 engines in half. And that's how the very early de Havilland engines began for the Moth series. Literally half of World War One V8. Colours of AT&T Air Transport and Travel. It was actually painted in that colour scheme in order to take part in a rather wonderful British Airways advert. You might have seen it when they go through the history of British Air Travel. Well, this was the biplane that took part in that advert for them. This aircraft is actually remarkably important. Even though they only built three of them, Geoffrey de Havilland learned so many lessons from it. First of all, don't stick a V8 in the nose. They're very expensive on spares, very expensive on fuel. People can't afford them. Don't make a great big three-seat aeroplane. Make the smallest practical aeroplane, simplest aeroplane you can with two seats in it. Consequently, all the lessons he learned from this aircraft, the DH-51, is what made the DH-60. H-51 landed at the far end of the field, running next to Bob Morecambe. Bring that aircraft, a very rare aircraft, to us today. Lovely to see it flying again. While taking centre stage, the Southern Air Master. Interesting aeroplane, designed by F.G. Miles, who of course went on to found his own Miles aircraft company near Reading.
Yeah. used by the US Navy during the Second World War, but acquired also by the Royal Air Force, one of the aircraft that helped close the Atlantic Gap. Very long-range patrol aircraft based on Lochearn in Northern Ireland, in places like Killadeers and Castle Armstead. Flying aircraft there, and it was North Atlantic. Trainers of the 1950s.
one camel, a light series bomb carrier, carry four 20-pound cuba bombs under the fuselage. First flew in April 1934. Before the Second World War started, 205 of these aircraft were built for civilian use. Interestingly, two of them for the AA used to fly around in the yellow and black colours of the AA. Very spectacular.
Yeah.